Hello, gorgeous. Today I want to talk about this idea that I came across, and that is just because you wear a dress and makeup doesn't make you feminine. And this was very interesting for me, especially as a woman. I considered myself an independent woman. I had previously been in my riverbed or my more doing mode most of my life, building my skills, building up my career, being in that building phase. And especially with the way I grew up, I was more of a tomboy. And so I did not grow up desiring to wear dresses, right? And so I kind of distanced myself a little bit from this idea of being feminine. And, going through my experience, building my career, building that riverbed, eventually I got to a point where I felt like something was missing. And really, it was this idea of reconnecting with my feminine essence. And I'm going to be doing more videos on this. But I just wanted to do this video because I am in a dress today. I'm very much enjoying being in a dress these days. I'm loving it and just reconnecting with that side that I had shut off. That side of me that I felt like I was not a part of, or I didn't connect with. And when I eventually got married and I was in a relationship, bits and parts of me started to kind of pop up. And, you know, when you're by yourself, it's easy to pick and choose what you want to do. But when you're starting to life hold together with someone and you're starting to create a life, you kind of have to pick and choose from a balance standpoint, right? Because if one person's doing one thing and the other person's doing the same thing, you're gonna have a lot of the same stuff. And eventually that kind of gets boring. And so, you know, becoming a, or, you know, developing and being part of a marriage, being part of a union is another word that I like to call it. And then also, when I became a stepmom, this opened me up more. It's the craziest thing. I used to love to drive fast. I think I got this from my dad. He was in the Navy for a short period of time, and he was on an aircraft carrier, and as part of their training, they had to go up in jets. And so he always talked about how he loved that experience and just the speed. And he always enjoyed fast cars, growing up. And I got that from him. But I will tell you, and this is crazy, because even though my stepsons are not my, you know, biological children, a weird thing, literally, it was a switch that flipped. Before meeting them, I still loved to drive fast every now and then. But the second they sat in my car, the very first time, I never went fast again. It's not that, like, something got taken. It's like a switch flipped on. It was like a protective switch. And, you know, sometimes I used to, you know, risk running the orange light and maybe I'll make it, things like that. And when they got in the car that first time, I did not do it ever again. And it's interesting how I started to notice that the way I was being and who I thought I was, like, that was it. But when little things like this happen in my life, where it's almost a switch gets flipped on and I surprise myself. I mean, I never thought that, you know, that this would be a new me. But this took me down the path of starting to explore and learn more about feminine energy and being more about the river versus the riverbed, to understand why things were happening the way they were. And this probably comes from my background. I studied psychology in university and I ended up going into marketing. That's a long story, but I've always had this deep curiosity of why do people do the things they do? Why am I and why do I do some of the things that I do, even when it's a reaction and I'm not thinking about it? And so I wanted to share this story because this was kind of freeing for me when I heard, just because a woman is wearing makeup and a dress doesn't make her feminine. And she shared that there are a lot of women who dress like this, but that are very masculine on the inside. They have a protective armor up. They are hard with their energy. And I even know some women like this. They are dressed and wearing makeup and wearing a dress, but with their energy, they're very masculine. They're all about, you know, getting things done, to-do lists, outcome oriented, you know, very harsh, like pushing constantly and making things happen. And in our early stages, yes, sometimes we need to be there, but understanding that when you are hard on the outside, but soft on the inside, right? A lot of these women that I knew, you know, came across as, you know, very firm, but the second something emotionally threw them off, they just crashed. And so not having that emotional control. This was very, very opening for me in my life. It definitely woke me up, and it woke me up to redefining what does it mean to have a feminine essence? What does it mean to also access your feminine energy? What are the health benefits of also accessing your feminine energy? And what are ways that you can do that? And I'm gonna be diving into this more in some of my feminine energy videos. So definitely check those out. I'd love to hear from you in the comments. Are you still operating very much in your doing phase, your masculine phase? Do you feel cut off from your feminine, or do you feel like you have started to learn about some of these concepts and practices and embodiments, right? Because the masculine and the riverbed is all about what you can do with the head and information and thinking and logic. Have you learned how to drop down into your body in a healed way? And so definitely let me know, and I look forward to catching you in the next one. Bye.